speaker. So join Carl Olson as he shows many of the keys he has used in his work with his business, Energizer Olson presentations. In his work with EOP, he has had the pleasure of conducting programs for over 1 million people and has authorized 2 successful books that have sold nearly 50,000 copies. In this workshop, participants will be given tools to help them increase their leadership impact. These tools will give ideas to improve presentations, inspire, motivate, and increase personal connections. The presentation will be fast-paced, hands-on, and inspirational and fun. Olson uses magic in his work, and he wants to share this magic with you. So here's Carl Olson.
Hey, my name's Carl. Everybody say hi, Carl. Okay, and you guys have been sitting quite a bit, and what I want you to do is this. Everybody's who wants to win a fabulous prize from me? Everybody turn face this way, and we'll have a contest with me right now. Okay, I'm gonna have a contest with you. Stand up. Stand up, just stay right there. Okay, put one hand behind your back. When I say go, you hold out your hand with any number of fingers. You can't use 0, and you can't use the number 1. Why do you suppose I'm not using the number 1? Think of something bad that could happen if we allowed him to use the number 1. Oh, okay, hear my voice clap once. No, come on, hear my voice clap once, twice, 3 times. And if I did this and I didn't say that, there were some people that would be giving each other the finger thinking that was funny. Does that show good character? So see, leadership and what you're talking about, I heard these students talking about stress and so forth, but your character saves you from stress if you know to do the right thing. So, and if I didn't say that, and some people did that, I think there's the presses here. If they saw young people doing that, what would they say about this conference? So what you want to do is, I shouldn't have to do that because you guys all have good character. But anyway, let's go ahead. I'll say ready, set, go. Ready, set, go. 5. I won because 2 + 3 = 5, and I added it faster than you. You know how to play now? Oh, good, good, good. Ready, set, go. 8. I win again. Okay, now come on. You're not very good at math, are you? Okay. I want you to win this time. Ready, set, go.
5, 7.
So, stop and see me. I have a good, better bracelet for you. Give him a hand. Okay, here's what I want you. You guys got to turn around. Everyone's facing this way, so it's like a theater. Here's what I want. While I get set up here, you're going to play someone 2 out of 3. Ready, set, go, go, go. Hear my voice clap once. Hear my voice clap once. Twice. 3 times. Hear my voice clap once. Twice. Okay, everybody say focus.
Focus.
Raise your right hand right now. Say, I promise.
I promise.
To focus. On the third clap. Hey, I only have 40 minutes. I've got a ton of magic that I want to do for you, and I want to send some messages. And if I can get you to focus on the third clap, we'll get a lot done. It's not that hard. Hear my voice clap once, twice. We're going to test your focus first. I'm not going to hypnotize you. I don't hypnotize people. But I'm going to start this spinning right like this. You need to focus on the center for 30 seconds. The last 5 seconds, I count down 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. When I get to 1, you don't look at this anymore. You look at my nose or look at me up here. And if you look at my nose, my head will shrink. Ready, set, go. 30 seconds. That's 5 seconds. Doing a good job. Okay, we're almost halfway there. Keep going, keep going. I'm going to count and look at my nose. 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. Clap once, twice. Is that cool or what?
Yeah.
You know what? I want to feel the energy in the room. So I'm going to do it again. This time I'm going the other way. My head's going to expand. Now, if you ask a question, you might say, is it okay if you blink? And I would say, yeah, it's okay if you blink. But what you have to do is you have to stare at it and have it pull you in. There are some people in this room that it will not work for. That has nothing to do with your intelligence. It's the way your brain works. Some people, it doesn't work for them. How many people have ever seen those books where the dots are there and something's supposed to jump out at you? Never jumps out at me. It just never, I never see it. So don't feel bad if it doesn't work for you, but let's see if you can really focus. I want to feel the energy in this room. Ready, set, go. 30 seconds. Doing a great job. That's about 10 seconds right there. I can feel the energy right now. Okay, coming up on 10 seconds to go. 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. Hear my voice clap once, twice, three times. That was awesome. Okay, we're going to go really, really fast. I'll hang around for the rest of the day. I'd like to come and meet some of you teacher or advisors that are here. They gave you a folder for me. There's some really neat things in there. I'll be able to tell you how they work. What I want you to do is fill out that white card and put it in here. We're going to have a drawing for a free Energizer Olson presentation at your school for staff or students. And if you give me the card also, I've got some great handouts that I'm going to be sending to you as well. Teachers like handouts. Hear my voice clap once, twice, three times. This is me, okay? And I'm jealous of everybody in this room. Dropped my clicker. Okay, hang on, it's falling apart. Hear my voice clap once, twice, three times. I'm jealous of everybody in this room. You have technology in your life that I never dreamed of. I remember when TV started. We had two channels, screen was this big. Technology in my lifetime was tinfoil on the rabbit ears. You have no idea what I'm talking about, but there's some people in this room that do. You know, we had telephones. I gotta tell you what, how many people in here have a computer at home? How many people have iPad, iPod? How many people have a cell phone? Everybody does, right? Make sure yours is off. I gotta tell you what, right now, at home, first of all, May 30th of last year was a big day in my life. It's my 50th wedding anniversary. You wanna clap for that one? Understand that you're clapping for her and not me, okay? I don't know why she chose me, but she's fantastic, and I love my wife, and I love to tease her. So what I want to do right now, she is, she's at home. She's probably still in her pajamas right now, okay? Probably watching one of her favorite TV shows. We had a big weekend, and I want to tease her. I want to call her on my cell phone. When I get her on the phone, I want you guys to say, hey, Kathy, get to work. Would you do this for me? Because if you do this, this would be so cool, okay? Let's practice it on three. Ready? 1, 2, 3. Oh, I can't wait to get her because I have a hot wife. No, that's a bad joke. She's beautiful, gets more beautiful every day, and we're here. Now, do I have your attention? Are we ready to go? Hear my voice clap once, twice, three times. So the thing is, I'm fired up. I'm gonna give you my best for 40 minutes. I'd like to meet some of you afterwards. I think it's so cool that you're here. I got to speak at this a couple times like 4 or 5 years ago, and I'm so thrilled to be back. Understand, they don't do this everywhere. The Fox Valley YMCA and the people that put this together, United Way, we need to make sure we thank those people because they do great stuff. Anyway, tell you what, two truths and a lie. I'll get you to learn some things about me. I'll tell you three things. You know what, I'm related to a movie star. How many people have played Two Truths and a Lie? Have you? Okay, I'm gonna tell you three things. I'm related to a movie star, very famous movie. Hold that thought, could be a lie. Fact number two, I have a dog named Joey. Could be a lie. Fact number three, how many people saw the movie The Mighty Ducks? It was a hockey movie. Have you seen that one? They had Mighty Ducks too, I was in it. Okay, you get one vote. How many don't think I'm related to a movie star? Raise your hand. How many don't think I have a dog named Joey? Raise your hand. How many don't think I was in The Mighty Ducks? Okay, let's take a look here, all right? Fact number one, this means very little to a lot of you, but that's Clayton Moore, okay? He was the Lone Ranger. This is the guy I watched every Saturday morning when I was growing up. And then I went to college, and I was sitting in the union, and this beautiful girl walked in. I said to my friend, I said, who's that? He said, that's Kathy Bacool. Her uncle's the Lone Ranger. I said, that's it, I'm marrying her, okay? My wife's uncle was the Lone Ranger, and I got to go to his house, and I got a silver bullet, and it's way cool. Fact number two, how are we doing here? Back to number two, Mighty Ducks. This is Wisconsin, okay? Mighty Ducks was filmed in Minneapolis right here. And we had a kid in our school that looked like one of the Mighty Ducks. And they put out a call for screen tests. He go over, he became a double in the movie because he looked exactly like one of the kids in the movie. And while his mom was there, they said, we need 100 middle school students for crowd scenes. And she asked. See, the key is asking. You've got to ask. She said, well, I think our school could send 100 kids over. Imagine this. We have 400 students in our school. You get to get out of school for 2 days, stay in a water park hotel, get dressed up and hang around with movie stars. How many of you would do that? Yeah, do you think we took anybody that got in trouble all the time? You think we took anybody that was behind in their work? No, but it was so cool. And I'm in the movie twice going, want to see that again? You don't even get to talk. It was the most boring thing that I ever did in my life. But the kids loved it. And there's all kinds of opportunity that's going to come along for you. And what you want to do is you got to be able to ask and be there when it happens. Hey, I must not have a dog named Joey then, right? How many people in here have ever had a pet that died? We had Joey for 15 years. He was the star of the Barron County Fair. We were big 4-H'ers. And when he got sick, we had a family meeting. They made me take him to the vet to be put to sleep. You know, I'd come to the back door every day and he'd be there and he'd take me for a walk is what he would do, okay? And for a month afterwards, he wasn't there and I'd start to cry. What do you know about me? I was in a movie, I'm sort of related to a movie star, and I'm a sensitive guy. See, that specialness about me. There is specialness about everybody in this room. And your job as a leader is to help bring that out. How many people in here have ever transferred schools in their life? Tell them how hard it is. What we need is we need leaders to help people through that process, because it can be pretty depressing when you go someplace you don't know anybody. Hear my voice clap once, twice. Okay, I'm gonna teach a magic trick right now. Everybody put your hand out like this. Everybody reach over and grab like this, nice and tight, nice and tight. Okay, you guys got it over there? Then you go like this. No, pay attention, come on. Listen up, we can do this. Thumb down. Tight, it's gotta be tight, it's gotta be really, really, you guys got it over there? And you go like this and see, I can do that and you can't. Hear my voice clap once, twice, three times. The reason I can do it and you can't is I know something you don't know. I didn't tell you everything. You know what I liked? I asked you to put your hand out like this and you did. I asked you to reach over and you did. You know how to listen and follow directions. But then magicians pull a trick. This is a Houdini opening thing that he used to do. And what I'm gonna do is I'm gonna tell you the trick. I let go and I pointed over there one time and over there another time. Instead of reaching back over, I reached under and go like this. Raise your right hand. Say, I promise to help my neighbor. Okay, so it's hand out like this. Reach underneath, thumbs up. You all help. I want everyone to be able to do it in the next 30 seconds. Ready, set, go. Gotta work together. Time, hear my voice clap once. How many people can do it now? Okay, and the thing is, the noise you made is what we need in any kind of leadership group, anything that you do. It sounds like this. See, you're working together and you're helping each other. I'm not leading you. Okay, here we go. Here's what I want. Oh, we got to go back one. Back one. I want you to do is this. I want you to connect all 9 dots with 4 straight lines. Use your finger. Once you put your finger down, you can't lift it up again. You can't go back over a line. Ready, set, go. If you know how to do it, don't tell anybody. 4 straight lines. And so many people have seen this before. You look so funny. And it's pretty hard, and this is the solution. Line number 1, line 2, line 3, line 4. What did I do that you hadn't thought of? What did I do that you hadn't thought of? Everybody say thinking outside the box. Everybody say thinking outside the box. Okay, where you're in freshman year, you're going to high school. What we want you to do is think outside the box. Steve Jobs, Bill Gates, the guy that invented Amazon. These are people that thought outside the box. We need to continue to do that because you have a lot to take care of in our world. Okay, what we're gonna do is this. Everybody needs a partner right now. If you don't have a partner, 3 people can work together. We're gonna talk about the 3 C's of leadership that I like. Here, let me get this thing, okay? And the first C is communication. Everybody say communication. I know this. I used to teach 4th grade. If I said I need a volunteer, they would probably kill each other trying to volunteer. If I asked for, the hands were going up all the time. And what happens when you get to adolescence, those hands don't go up anymore because you don't want to single yourself out. Okay, and you've got to be a communicator. You've got to get better at it. We've talked to over 1.5 million people now. We've sold 50,000 books, all because we ask. We ask questions. You do not want to sit next to me on an airplane. I'm telling you this right now. Not if you want peace and quiet, because I'm going to get to know you, okay? And it's what you have to do. You have to be a good communicator and find ways to do it. So who has a partner and wants to win a fabulous prize for me? Well, okay, you two, stand up right there. Stand up back to back. We got to do this fast. Okay, now look at me. I'm going to give you three symbols. First symbol is moose. Do moose. And then elephant. And then couch potato. You have to, this is going to be poor communications because you don't know what the other person's doing. When I say go, you can do this, this, or this. You turn around, face your partner. If you match, you get to sit down. If you don't match, you got to go again in my direction, and you can't communicate. Do moose again. Do elephant. Do couch potato. Okay, ready, set, go. Turn around, turn around. Yay, didn't match. Everybody stand up with their partner right now. Let's go, let's go, let's go. Everybody do moose. Elephant. Three people can stand back to back. Couch potato. Okay, number one, if you match, you get to sit down. Ready, set, go. Sit down if you matched. Number two, ready. If you didn't match, you're going again. Ready, set, go. Number three, one more time. Ready, set, go. Go ahead and sit down. Hear my voice clap once, twice, three times. And the whole thing is, if you talk to each other, you would match every time. It's called communication. You just have to get better at it. Communication is really important. The second C for me would be competition. I get in schools all over the country, all over the world actually, and I see young people that don't get involved because they might lose or their friends aren't doing it. And if you don't do what you want to do, you're a freshman now, if you get to your senior year and if there's something you want to do, you haven't done it, you're going to have regrets. You don't want to have regrets. So we're going to have a contest right now. Okay, I'm going to give you three symbols. First symbol, surfer. Everybody do surfer. Okay, second symbol is wave. Everybody do wave. And the third symbol is girl, okay? Hear my voice clap once, twice. I do not mean that in a degrading or sexist way. But I want to make a point. Right now, 64% of college students are female. And they say by the time you get there, it might approach 70%. Why? Because girls, you know how to get your work done, and you take responsibility. And I'm not saying, hey, I'm a guy. I'm not putting guys down, okay? But basically, it's girl power, gang. Everybody, girl power, come on right here. And you have to keep doing it because it's going to make everybody else better. How many people watch the Super Bowl? San Francisco 49ers had one of their coaches was a female. And she's there because she's good, not because they just wanted her. So we have to, girls, we need you to keep doing great. And boys, you got to follow and take responsibility. So what's going to happen is this. It's like rock, paper, scissors. If I do surfer, you're going to stand back to back. Partner does wave, I win because the surfer gets the wave. If I do wave and my partner does girl, I win because the wave gets the girl. It messes her hair up. I've never had hair, okay? The girl beats the surfer every time. Let's talk our way through it. Everybody say surfer. Beats. Okay, wave beats girl. Girl beats. Could you tie? Could you tie? You could both do the same thing. And if I said, now what do? People would say, do over. You got to have a winner and a loser. That's not what Stephen Covey would say. Stephen Covey would call that a win-win because you both tried. You both tried. Okay, let's talk our way through it one time. Then we're going to have a contest. We're going to go four times. Everybody say, surfer. Beats. Back to back. Here we go. You're going to go four times. See if you can beat your partner. Number one, ready, set, go. Number two, ready, set, go. Number three, ready, set, go. Number four, ready, set, go. Go ahead and sit down. Hear my voice clap once, twice, three times. See, competition can be fun. You've got to try stuff. Put yourself out there. It's what we want to do. And the last thing would be care. The reason that this thing has been here for 20 years is some people really care. The people who started it and the people who have continued it and the volunteers who help with it. Make sure you say thanks and make sure you realize how lucky you are to have something like this. All right, so toolbox. You got to have tools for your toolbox. I am 74 years old, okay? So we're going to teach a magic trick right now. And I was a wrestler in college, and I have a bad neck. So what I have to do when I get up in the morning, I look in the mirror, I have to go like this. Plastic cup under your arm, okay? Here we go. You're going to, hey, I want you to learn some magic. This is so, you can do this. Pick out your favorite teacher. Get a hard plastic cup. If you don't have a hard plastic cup, you can use an empty soda bottle with the cap off. Can you imagine? You go to Mr. Johnson. You put this under your arm and say, Mr. Johnson, I was at this conference and I didn't get my assignment done. And the reason is because I slipped and fell and I hurt my arm and I really... How many people are going to do that trick? Hear my voice clap once, twice, three times. I'll tell you where I learned it. Penn and Teller. Penn and Teller are famous Las Vegas magicians. I try to see every magician I can in the world. I saw them in Vegas, and they said, we just wrote a book called How to Play in Traffic. And they were in the lobby afterwards. $25, they'd sign your book. I got right in line, got there. And this trick that I just showed you is in the book. And I saw it, and I'm writing my second book, and I wanted to put it in there, and I'm not going to steal from them. So I wrote Penn and Teller, and I asked. I said, my name's Carl Olson. I saw you in Vegas. I like the neck cracker. That's what they called it. I'd like to put it in my next book. I have a signed letter in my office from these world-famous magicians. It says, Carl, good luck with the book. Use the trick. Please send us a copy. Why? Because I ask. It is not hard. Put your hand out like this right now. You don't reach over, you reach under. It is not rocket science. It's being brave enough to ask. Hear my voice clap once, twice. I'm going to speed right along. Okay, I'll show you another one. I learned this when I was 10 years old. It's in my YouTube channel. I need subscribers, okay? Carl Energizer. It's in a chapter in my book. Everybody take out a pencil right now. Hold it like this. Really quickly. I don't want to waste a lot of time with this. Okay, you take your pencil, you move it from here to here, and then back to there. Or you start down here, and you come like that, and go, hey, you look really funny doing that. No, try it again. Here we go. Pencil's here, goes to there. And you know what I like about this? I learned it when I was 10 years old. 10 years old I learned it, and it went in my toolbox. Now I've showed it to over 1 million people. And I want people to remember me. They don't normally remember Carl Olson, but they remember the pencil trick. I'm in Times Square, New York. I had talked to this big group in Omaha. And this lady comes up to me in Times Square, New York, and says, aren't you that pencil trick guy? And at that point, I got to know Mary. Now Mary and I exchange ideas. All because I learned something when I was 10 years old. And if you want to learn how, I'll be around at lunch. I'll give lessons for $10 an hour. Okay? But what I'm saying to you is you don't know what you're going to use and what you're going to gain. So pencil trick, we got a couple things. I'm going to give you a quiz right now. And this is something I really, truly believe in. And anybody who's around me knows what I'm talking about. The human brain has 70 trillion synapses, and nobody's wired the same. But there's lots of places to store information. You can never fill it up. I'm going to start a quiz. I'll give you a quiz. I'll start a commercial. You finish it. Silly rabbit, tricks are for? Oh, wow. Do they teach that in your school? How about this one? I wish I were an Oscar Mayer. Do you really? That knowing that gives you nothing. I even know the song. I wish I were an Oscar Mayer wiener. That is what I'd truly like to be. I don't sing very well. But if I were an Oscar Mayer wiener, everyone would be in love with me. Why do I know that? What good does that do me? Nothing, but there's room for stuff. So I'm going to put something in there today that I think is really important. You guys are here because you're good. But you need to always try to get better. Because in the end, I want you to be your best. I didn't say the best. I don't want you to be the, I love they were talking about pressure. And I thought, a lot of people think they have to be the best at everything. No, you have to be your best. I went to Jeff McBride's magic school. I spent $1,000 to spend 7 hours with the world champion illusionist. You guys, he had 7 hours free. Chris Angel goes there for lessons, and I got to spend 7 hours with this guy. It was amazing. I could never be Jeff McBride. I wouldn't even try. He has skills that I don't possess. But guess what? I have skills that I know I need to be better. So your key is, it's good, better, best. Never let it rest. So your good is better and better is best. And it's your best, not the best. Please keep that in mind. All right, so the saying goes like this. You're good. You need to try to get better because I want you to be your best. It comes from the 16th century Saint Jerome. It's been around since then. I've used it every day for 30 years. I say it twice, in the morning, before when I get up, and before I go to bed. Because you've got to believe in yourself. And it's an affirmation. So it goes like this. Good, better, best. Never let it rest. So your good is better and better is best. And you will know this, and she's going to help me with a $100 magic trick if you do a good job on it. Four verses. First verse, I say good, better. You say best. Good, better?
Best.
You can do better than that. Good, better?
Best.
Not good enough. Good, better?
Best.
Good, better?
Best.
Think of the sequence. See, we don't, good's not good enough. You're not getting a good conference today. Yeah, they've learned and they try to make it better every year. Good, better?
Best.
Good, better?
Best.
Second verse, I say never let it, you say rest. Never let it?
Rest.
Never let it?
Rest.
Good, better?
Rest.
Never let it?
Rest.
Third verse, I say till your good is and you say better because you want to make your good better. Till your good is?
Better.
Till your good is?
Better.
And the last verse, your better is best. Okay, let's try it again. Good, better? Now, $100 magic trick if you do a good job. Good, better?
Best.
Come on. Good, better?
Best.
Never let it?
Best.
Till your good is?
Better.
Better is?
Best.
Let's go real fast. Good, better, never let it till you're good. Let's go real slow. Let me go real slow. Good, better,
best.
Never let it
best.
Till your good is?
Better.
And your better is?
Best.
What's your name? What? Casey, now you're going to have to talk really loud because I told you to think of a card, right? And it's going to be this card. At Jeff McBride's Magic School, we worked on mentalism, you know, reading people's minds. I'm in your head right now, and it's really scary. I got to tell you that. You have no idea what she's thinking about, but I do, okay? All right. Wouldn't this be a good trick if this is it Casey? If this is Casey's card. Everybody shake your head yes. Okay, Casey, tell everybody what your card is. Four of Hearts is right there. How many people think this is a pretty dumb trick? How many people think it's not worth $100? You know what a fifth grade boy said to me? He said, you paid $100 for that? And you'd be right, because this is, it has parts of all cards. And it's barely good. We need to make it better. I'm going to show this to you. I'll turn my head away. You need to pick a card that you can see. You can see the Ace of Spades. Don't use that one. You know, for example, there's a queen, but you don't know what queen it is. So you help her, and you both get, you got my bracelet. So pick out a card, lock in your memory bank. It's got to be card and suit. You need more time. You got one? Okay, wouldn't this be better if the next card I pull out of here is her card? Wouldn't it be better? Give me drum roll right now. Drum roll. Drum roll. Stop. Stop. It is her card, okay? Who said that? No, who said that? Stop afterwards. I got a good, better, best bracelet for you. Okay, we got to make it better. What was your card? What was it? Like the Three of Clubs, right? You can clap for that one if you want, okay? Hear my voice clap once, twice, three times. That card trick had three levels to it. First level was really dumb. Second level was kind of funny. The last level was wow. And I want you to have a wow time today. I want you to have a wow next 3 years of school. I want you to have a wow life. Watch this, I can spell wow. Hey, backwards. How many of you would do that in front of a group of people? I would. I have no trouble doing it. On three, I want everyone to give me a wow right now. Ready, set, wow. Okay, you can do better than that, come on. Ready, set, wow. And your mom does not live here, so take care. Hear my voice clap once, twice, three times. Good, better.
Best.
Good, better.
Best.
Good, better.
Best.
Never let it.
Best.
Till your good is?
Better.
Better is?
Best.
Twice a day for 30 years, I have never missed a day. When I get up in the morning, I look in the mirror, and I say, hey, Carl, good, better, best. Never let it rest. Till your good is better, better is best. I got to believe in me. You have to find ways to do it. This is self-talk is really an important thing if you want to build your self-confidence. Tonight before I go to bed, I slow it down a little bit. I say, hey, Carl, hey, good, better, best. Never let it rest. Your good is better, better, best. Good day, man. And I can sleep comfortably. And I say it twice a day. You've got to find ways. Maybe this doesn't work for you, but you have to find ways to use self-talk and build your confidence. Hear my voice clap once, twice, three times. Okay, it's important that we have fun. I'm going to give you a test. I'm going to give you a test right now. All right, test. I can spell test. You got to name the incomplete animal in this drawing. Don't say it out loud. It's a pig. Okay, you got that one? Question two. Can you get through the maze? Question three. Can you find the word in this word search? Question four. Which one's different? Question five. Can you find the panda in the pickup truck? And question six, which is bigger? Oh, can you connect the dots? And the last one, which is bigger, the pineapple or the pea? Everybody put your hand out like this right now. Come on. This is not rocket science. Advisors, one of the things you're going to get from me is my whole PowerPoint. You can have it all. We've got some cool videos on here that I think you're going to like. Plus, I have two other files for you, too. So make sure you turn in one of those things because we'll have the drawing. You might get a free presentation. Hear my voice clap once, twice. It's important that we learn. I got to tell you what, you guys, I'm 74 years old and I hang around with old people. They're my friends. And I get to hang around with you guys too. They have no idea how good you are. You know what they say about you? All you guys do is text. You don't know how to work. You don't know, you don't have it as tough as I did when I was growing up. And I get so sick of hearing it because I have one foot with them and I have another foot with you guys. And I know how good you are. You know, this is a famous person said this. Our youth today love luxury. They have bad manners. And it goes blah, 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 blah. And it's Socrates, 400 BC. Someday you will be saying it about the younger generation as well. We need to build generational understanding. We need to do that, okay? So what we're going to do is this. I'm going to show you this video. This is a project that you could do. They did this at Kimberly. Steve Jones's class did this at Kimberly a few years back. It's called The Lost Generation. Understand, I work at the Challenge Academy. These are students that are 16 years, 8 months at least, and failing in school. They can sign up and volunteer to go to the National Guard Challenge Academy at Fort McCoy, and they spend 5.5 months there, and they change their lives. They're failing. They're not making it in school. And they spend 5.5 months there. They do all kinds of cool stuff. They get caught up on their work, and I get to go there 4 times a year, and I love it. I go to their graduation, and I bawl like a baby to see these kids, how they've changed their lives. You never give up on yourself and never give up on your friends. But anyway, so what I did is I recorded The Lost Generation with students who had been at the Challenge Academy 5 months. This is a poem that reads two ways, and I suggest this. I think at Brilliant, you get 13 students together and you could do this project. You video it, then you take it to your school board or you take it to your Lions Club because we have to build understanding. Let's roll it and we'll show you what it looks like. Ready, set, go. And you guys know how to do the video. I had to hire a guy.
I am part of a lost generation.
And I refuse to believe that.
I can change the world.
I realize this may come as a shock, but happiness comes from within is a lie.
And money will make me happy.
So in 30 years, I will tell my children they are not the most important thing in my life.
My employer will know that I have my priorities straight.
Because work is more important than family.
So this is what people say about your generation.
I tell you this, once upon a time, families stayed together, but this will not be true in my era.
This is a quick fix society.
Experts tell me that 30 years from now, I will be celebrating the 10th anniversary of my divorce.
I do not concede that I will live in a country of my own making.
In the future, environmental destruction will be the norm.
No longer can it be said that my peers and I care about this earth.
It will be evident that my generation is apathetic and lethargic.
It is foolish to presume that there is hope.
And all of this will come true unless we reverse
Same
it.
Same poem read backwards. Same poem
There
read
is
backwards.
Hope.
It is foolish to presume that my generation is apathetic and lethargic.
It will be evident that my peers do not care about this earth.
No longer can it be said that environmental destruction will be the norm.
In the future, I will live in a country of my own making.
I do not concede that 30 years from now, I will be celebrating the 10th anniversary of my divorce.
Experts tell me this is a quick fix society, but this will not be true in my era.
Families stay together. Once upon a time, I tell you this.
Family is more important than work.
I have my priorities straight because
my employer will know that they are not the most important thing in my life.
So in 30 years, I will tell my children.
Money will make me happy is a lie, and true happiness comes from within.
I realize this may be a shock, but I can't change the world.
And I refuse to believe that.
I'm part of a lost generation.
Is that good or what? I'd like to see every one of these schools put that together. Put it on YouTube. You got permission. Just go to the, you find it on YouTube. Any if you have some questions, see me later. Do those students look like losers to you? No, because they've changed their lives. And you as a leader, you've got to be a good listener too, because you can help get people in the right direction. Hear my voice clap once, twice, three times. Okay, besides character, a character trait is gratitude. It's sort of saying thanks, and I'd like to see you get better at this. I'd like to see you practice it. This is a Kleenex commercial. Let's go ahead here. Boom. Okay, this lady has cancer. Some of you may have seen it before. And this is a group of her former students that put this together for her. Some people are going to cry when they see this. Let's start at once. Gratitude.
Ms. Watson is my former chorus teacher from freshman year to senior year of high school. She's one of the best vocal teachers I've ever met.
I love my students, and I want them to have the best opportunities so that they can thrive.
Currently, I live in Los Angeles, and I'm pursuing a career in entertainment. I know I wouldn't have been able to do any of it if it hadn't been for Ms. Watson. The last time I seen her was some years ago in 2008, 2009, and I realized I never really had a chance to let her know exactly how influential she was to my life.
Some of us, we haven't seen each other in 10 years. We hear anything to do with Ms. Watson and we're like, we're there.
She's just gone through a rough patch with her health. So I just want to let her know that I love her and keep on pressing forward.
I know she's going to be really, really thrilled when she sees all of us.
Ms. Watson believes that she's getting ready to have a teacher interview at her school tomorrow. She's about to get a handful.
Amazing grace, how sweet the sound that saved a wretch like me. I once was lost, but now I found. Was blind, but now I see. Amazing grace, how sweet the sound that saved a wretch like me. I want.
How's that lady feel? How do the people feel who are doing it? See, gratitude's a two-way street. Ben Franklin, in order to change a habit or get rid of a bad habit, it says it takes 21 days of constant practice. I challenge you to do this. Pick out a time, starting today, maybe tomorrow, whatever, and for 21 days, try to be as gracious as you can be. Thank people all the time and keep doing it, because at the end of that 21 days, you're going to develop a habit that's going to help you forever. We adults, we like people that are great. We like people to say thank you. And it's not that hard. I'll give you a chance. I got two things to do, and then I'll finish up. I wish I could stay longer. But the whole point is this. I go to Simmons Middle School every year. It's a great gig. I talk to the sixth graders right before summer vacation. I've done it for 12 straight years. They even pay me for it, okay? And last year, I'm setting up my, and I can't wait because I get magic going and I'm going like crazy. And last year, I'm sitting there getting ready and I'm in the gym all by myself and one student walks in. Of course, I talk to sixth graders, find out he's a seventh grader. This young man walked up to me, looked me in the eye, shook my hand and said, Mr. Olson, and he introduced himself. And I said, wow, thank you. He said, yeah, I'm in seventh grade now. I said, yeah, I love coming here. He said, I remember your program last year. And I came in here to tell you something. I said, what's that? He said, you know that good, better, best thing you teach? I said, I teach it everywhere I go. I love it. I mean it. I try to live a good, better, best lifestyle. He said, you need to know that I've said that every day since then. And I've been on the A-plus honor roll ever since. And I want to thank you for that. He shook my hand, turned and left. How do you think I felt? You want to know what he did, though? This is a seventh grader. He presented himself to me. And too many times people your age are kind of shy about that, or you need someone to come with you. Yeah, you want to be respected. You don't want to be a silly middle school kid anymore. You want to be respected, and you have to know when you have to come up big. So we're going to practice some handshakes here. I'm going to start with you. Okay, stand up. Okay, everybody watch this. Now you can get a partner. Okay, what I want you to do is this. Hold out your hand like this. Okay, I'm going to show you. We're going to do the salmon handshake right here. Okay, and we go like this. Okay, what's your name? Callie, this is really great. Don't you love it here? Okay, everybody do salmon handshake with somebody right now. Come on, let's go. Salmon handshake. Stop, hear my voice loud once. We got another one for you, watch this. Hold out your thumb like this. I'll grab your thumb, grab my thumb. I'll grab your thumb. Lumberjack, how you doing? It's so great to see everybody do lumberjack right now. Let's go. Stop! Hear my voice clap once! I got one more for you. Go like this. Farmer, okay, how are you? Everybody do a farmer handshake. Hear my voice clap once! Twice! There are actually websites of handshakes. That's farcical. There's nothing farcical about stand up. You're shorter than me, but look me in the eye. And you tell me who you are and what you like to do, and you look me in the eye and you do it. This is what you need to do if you want to be respected, by adults especially. You can go play with your friends all you want, but there are times when you got to come up big, and you got to force yourself to be able to do that. Hear my voice clap once. Okay, I got to finish with this. I'm going to teach you a song. Okay, the song is Sweet Caroline, all right? You already know it, but let me tell you what, there's a history with it. Major League Baseball teams at the seventh inning stretch have traditions. Anybody ever been to Wrigley Field? Take me out to the ball game. They have a statue of Harry Carey singing it. I think they do that at the Brewer game too, right? Take me out to the ball game. In New York, the Yankees use God Bless America. In Boston, they use Sweet Caroline. And the reason is this, the guy who wrote it, Neil Diamond, had a crush on Caroline Kennedy, and she lived in Boston. So he wrote the song in honor of her. A few years back, we had a bombing. You were pretty young at that Boston Marathon. And yet, let me tell you what, I lived in Iran for 2 years. I taught there. I've been to Ghana, Africa. I've been just about all over Europe. Nobody has what we have. When something doesn't go well, we come up big. Anyway, this bombing happens, and the whole country is transfixed by it. And I'm watching Morning Joe, and this guy comes on. He says, you're not going to believe what happened in New York last night. See, the Yankees don't like the Red Sox. It's like Packers, Vikings, or Bears, Packers, whatever. He said, last night at the seventh inning stretch, the Yankees played Sweet Caroline in honor of the people in Boston. And then every major league team played it until the All-Star break. And the All-Star game was in Boston. And Neil Diamond grabbed a mic, went to center field, and the whole country sang Sweet Caroline in honor of this. Because this is what we do. This is what leaders do. Okay, if you haven't done it before, I'll teach you. When it goes to the chorus, you're going to be in Fenway Park right now, it goes Sweet Caroline, and then trumpets go bump, 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 and everybody goes like this, bump, bump, bump. Let's do that right here. We go, come on. Bump, bump, bump. Next line says it makes you feel so good, and three times you point at somebody, different people, you say, so good, so good, so good. Everybody do that right now. There's one part that says reaching out, and everybody reaches out like this. Then it says touching me, and you go like this. It says touching you, and you point at all your friends. All right, here we go. Everybody stand up right now. Let's go. Stand up. Let me get this out of the way. I want to hear you sing. Everybody, the first line is where it began. Everybody say where it began. All right, ready, set, let's go. Get the beat. Louder. Come on. Get the beat. All right, well, we're singing now. Okay, where it began. Here it comes. I want to hear you sing.
Where it began.
I can't begin to know it.
I can't begin to know it.
But I know it's growing strong.
But then I know it's growing strong.
Wasn't the spring.
Wasn't the spring.
Then spring became the summer.
And spring became the summer.
Who'd have believed you'd come along?
Who'd have believed you'd come along?
Here we go. Nice hands. Here we go. Get ready. I want to hear you.
hand.
Touching hands.
Touching hands.
You know what to do next.
Reaching out.
Touching me.
Touching me.
Enemy of great. Good is getting by when you could do better. I want you doing better. I want you to become your best. Good better. Not good enough. Good better. Come on, you can do better than that. Good better. Good better. Never let it. So your good is, better is. Hands up. Here we go. How can I hurt?
How can I hurt when holding you?
I say warm. Say warm.
Warm. Touching
you know
more.
The grill,
reaching out, touching me.
Good better. Come on. Good better. Not good enough. Good better. Never let it. Till your good is. Better is. I gotta finish with this. I'm 3 minutes over. Hear my voice clap once, twice, three times. I wanna finish with a soft and polite good, better, best. I got to go to Jamesville to the school for the deaf and blind. They wanted a magic show. They can't see. I said, I gotta come down early. And they didn't even pay me anything. I went down. We spent a whole day talking about touch. I pulled this long straw out of the bag and everything. And it was one of the meanest things I've done in my whole life. And I came away feeling so good about it. And they taught me that this is clapping in sign language. Okay? So we're going to finish with a soft and polite, good, better, best. If you liked it, give me this kind of clap. And I'm going to come around and give you a chance to win $1 this afternoon. Okay? Okay. Thanks for listening to me. You guys are awesome. Thank you.